Therefore, if the Son makes you free, that is Jesus, you shall be free indeed. So if Jesus makes you free, you will be free indeed. I don't have to add on to that. If he says he can free me, I'm accepting his freedom, amen?
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. If he says that he can set me free when I'm bound, I'm going to take him at his word. I'm not going to look at what I see, but I'm going to look up to him for his glory and his word that sets the cap. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. When he makes you free indeed. So today I'm going to look at this concept of freedom. The concept of freedom. And to a lot of us, it's just a concept. That's a sad thing about Christianity. It's just it's an idea of an ideal. But it's not in our lives. It's not an it's not an experience that we have in our Christian walk, because we allow the enemy to bind us in so many different ways. Amen.
Amen.
But today is the day.
Amen.
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 Amen. Well, I'm going for the amen in that.
Yeah.
If the Son sets me free, I'm free indeed. Amen. Do you want to be free?
Yes.
Do you want to be free?
Yes.
What is it to be free? It says to be free from human ways.
Yeah.
That I'm not longer caught in this world. It's not about me and the world and Jesus. It's about me and Jesus. It's about me and my God. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The world has no hope on me any longer. I'm free because the Son has set me free.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Colossians 2 verse 13 says this. When you are dead in your sins. When you are dead in your sins, that is who you used to be. When you were dead in your sins, and in the uncircumcision of your sinful nature, God made you alive. Oh. When I was dead, God found me. He took hold of me. He freed me from my sin. And he saved me and gave me his
yes.
Name. Yes. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Woo.
Says he forgave us all of our sins. All of our sins. Not just some of us. There's not a card in glory marked with all your sins and says, well, I've forgiven them for 20, doesn't it? Still another 20 to go here. The sheet is white.
Amen.
There's no ink on it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It says in verse 14, having cancelled the written code with its regulations that was against us and that stood opposed to us. You know what the Bible says? This is what God says. Before Jesus Christ, every one of us was under the sway of the wicked one. Did you know that?
Yes.
Every one of us was under the sway of the devil. The devil had hold of us and he was making us do things that we didn't do. And I know it's the sinful nature. I understand it's the flesh. But it says every one of us was under the sway of the wicked one. You don't need to tell me that. I knew I was wicked. I knew I was evil. I knew I was sinful. But if it was all those persons, Jesus revealed himself that I need a savior. I need a savior. I need a savior to save me. It says he came to dismantle the works of the devil in my life. Amen. He came to do away that I'm no longer under his power. I'm under the Lord's power. I'm now a son of God. I'm now a child of God. I'm now washed in his precious blood.
Thank you, Jesus.
As if I have never
yes.
been in my life. I think that sounds good, doesn't it? But this is what I want to get at this morning. And this is where our freedom is. And I got this while we were away on holiday. Verse 15 says this. And having disarmed, you need to hear this. I'm going to say that if I finish off this preach just quoting this verse, I will. Mm-hmm. This is what God says. Having disarmed the powers and the authorities, it says he, Jesus, made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them on the cross. Jesus disarmed the powers of darkness over your life, making a public spectacle of the devil. Triumphing. What does that mean? Yeah. You can go, oh, hallelujah, praise the Lord, that's amazing, that sounds good, but what does that mean? Yeah. What does that mean? Yeah. Well, it means that the devil no longer has any power over my life.
Yes!
That the Lord has broken the power of the devil over my life. Amen.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! You know, years ago in Christian church, we used to have this saying, don't really use it any longer because we don't do much warfare in the church. That's the truth. We don't do much warfare in the church. We counsel. We massage. We put a pillow under people's sin. We don't offend. We're politically correct. We don't mention the devil. Don't mention it.
Mm.
But years ago in the church, we used to have a saying. And I believe this is where this saying comes from. And we are going to bring this saying back into our church. Amen.
Amen.
And the saying was this. Get behind thee, Satan.
Mm.
It's in the Bible, Jesus rebukes Peter. Get behind thee, Satan. We used to have that saying in church. We don't say it any longer. You have no authority over me.
Yeah.
Get behind thee, Satan.
Yeah.
And this is where that verse of scripture, having disarmed the powers and the principalities, he made a public spectacle of them. What this is saying here is in Roman times, amen. In Roman times, listen to this song, we're going to enjoy this. In Roman times, when you defeated your enemy, amen. You used to bound your enemy with chains. Amen. And then you used to get your enemy and you parade your enemy behind you. Get behind me, my chains, become his chains. Instead of him parading me like a drug addict or somebody that's depressed or an alcoholic, I am now parading. See, this is significant for us folks. It is significant for us in this church.
Absolutely.
I was saying to Brenda yesterday, I said, Brenda, you know, we're not just on the gates of hell. We're literally in it. Literally in it. And I know there's people that are hurt because of people belonging to them that have passed this week. But there's about 4 or 5 people in the last 10 days in this area. I'm going to a funeral tomorrow. Long lost friend of mine, John, died of a heart attack, a drug addict, a crack addict. And I said to Brenda yesterday and the day before, this is not right. It's not right.
No.
That the enemy is running riot in their land. We need to be on our knees, on our faces, crying out to God for mercy over these people, that we will see them saved, not being presumptuous with the faith that we've received, but going to war.
Yes.
Going to war.
Yes.
Going to war.
Yes. Yes.
Get behind thee, Satan.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Making a public spectacle over them. I was thinking about McGregor yesterday. And a lot of us come into this category when we get saved. We become churchy. And we forget that it's a battle and it's a fight. Give the fight every day for your salvation.
Yeah.
It says walk out your salvation with fear and with trembling. I'm grateful. I'm full of gratitude. But now I have a warring spirit in me that wants to fight against the powers and the principalities and the spirits of the air, because I've seen the destruction of them on my family, my friends, and my loved ones. I want to go to war against them because God has given me the authority to put on my foot. It's freedom if you want to walk in it. So a lot of us get so accustomed to being bound. And we don't realize there's no lock on the chains. We're carrying the chains that God has released us from.
Amen.
A lot of us are walking around in darkness for years. Not knowing there's a light switch right in front of you. Do you ever go into a dark room and you're walking around and you're feeling for the light? Yeah. Well, the light switch is there, just look for it. Don't sit in the car. Look for the switch. Turn it on and walk out your freedom. Amen.
Amen. Yes.
You get what I'm saying? You see, there's still power in the blood of Jesus. The cross of Calvary still has the same power today, yesterday, and forever.
Amen.
Has it lost its power because God went to glory? He says, it's God in me, Christ in me, the hope of glory. And he has given me and you authority. Isn't that right, Jesus?
Thank you, Jesus.
Man, there's so many defeated Christians. Truly, I'm telling you, I'm not being disrespectful. You're living a defeated life because you don't know the fruit. You will know the fruit. It is the devil. Bigger than Jesus. No way. He's a created being. God is the creator of all things.
Yes.
He's above all things. He is in all things. He is through all things. In his hand, he holds it all together. Nothing happens in this world without his say-so.
Amen.
Are you getting what I'm saying here?
Yeah.
So I was thinking about McGregor. What I was thinking about, you know, when he won his belt. He was a champion, wasn't he?
Mm.
Had a belt to prove it, didn't he?
Yeah.
Didn't he? Yeah, he walked around with the belt, look at me. Yeah. Yeah. Had the belt. He was a champion. Probably had a little care to say, McGregor is a champion. Then he gets into the ring and he gets the head boxed off him. Wasn't a champion any longer. Do you know what I mean? Because he let go of what he had received. He thought, I'm a champion now, so I can live the way I please. I can live as the world please. I don't have to train 8 hours any longer to keep that fight in me. I can just carry on being who I am. I'm a champion. I have to care to say it. You get what I'm saying? I'm a champion because I'm living as a champion. You're a champion because you're living as a champion. Not because you have a belt or a certificate. You're a champion because you're living as a champion. Yes, the Bible says that we fight not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and the spirits of the air. That's what God says we fight against. It says these things cannot be beaten with guns or knives or even the placard of a belt. Christ in me. So I was thinking about the last month. I was telling you, going through stuff. I says it before I went away. And you're hearing this voice we were talking about, and the voice of, you know, coming against your faith. Oh, you're going to die. You're going to, whatever it was. And I was thinking about the voice. And what is the voice that you listen to? What voice do you listen to? When you're going through stuff, is it the small, still voice? Are you like me? Going through that, I listen to the wrong voice. Of a pimple, Lord. It's a tumor. That's blokes.
Yeah.
It's men. I'm telling you. That we have to live with. But the thing about it is, I thought about that mic, I thought about that voice that was speaking into my life, and I was thinking about the scripture. So I have a voice speaking into my life or your life. Well, a voice needs a mouth, doesn't it? Can't speak without a mouth, can you? You can't. It's not Mick Jagger, you know, the teeth that used to be out there years ago. The voice needs a mouth. A mouth needs a face. And a face needs a body. So the voices sometimes that we're listening to are the wrong voices. Not flesh and blood. Powers and principalities and spirits in heavenly places. Amen. That is what we are warring against as Christians and fighting against. But listen to what it says in Matthew 18. Truly I tell you, whatever you bound in heaven and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed. That's what he says. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed. We have power over the wicked. We have power over the powers and principalities. We have power over addiction. We have power over depression.
Amen.
We have power over fear.
Yes.
We have power over anxiety.
Yes.
We have power to put the enemy underfoot. We have power to live a victorious life in Jesus Christ. We have power to live an abundant life in the Lord Christ. We have power. We have power.
Yes.
Whatever you bound will be bound in heaven, in the heavenly places. That voice that's speaking, those words that are putting you down, you need to start speaking back to that voice.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah.
You need to shut your ears off to that voice, and you need to start telling that voice
what you
to
say?
Get behind
yes.
in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I am taking off those chains.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You are carrying my chains from this day power.
Hallelujah.
I just think that's a beautiful picture.
Oh, yes.
Isn't that what it is to be bound?
Yes.
What am I bound in with? Cotton wool.
No.
I got to bound in with cotton wool and counsel the demon. Here you go. You just take a little place there. Have a rest. You've been tormenting me for 20 years. It must have been hard for you. It must have been, because all you know the type of person I am. You know what I mean? Come on!
Yeah.
You had a hard job. It was a bit of cotton wool.
How are you feeling?
A cup of tea. Do you want a cup of tea? Well, come on, folks.
Yeah.
This stuff is real.
Yeah.
This stuff is real. We're seeing it.
Yes.
Like Sharon, we're seeing it.
Yes.
People are dropping all around us.
Yeah.
The enemy is running riot. And as the people of God, we have been given authority to put the enemy
yes.
under foot. Amen.
Amen.
We're not going around with the belt and living a defeated life because you're not a winner. You're not a champion. Amen.
Yes.
But a lot of us are walking around still in that room looking for the light switch. Just sitting in the corner waiting for God to turn up and put on the switch. You won't give me a darkness. But there's loads of testimonies in this room of being bound by the enemy for so long with drugs and alcoholic and fear and anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
And you see Jesus setting people free. Well, if he's done it for me, he'll do it for you.
Amen.
Because he loves you every bit as much as he loves me.
Amen.
He says he's not a respecter of person. The same love that he has for me, or maybe his favourite, but the same love that he has for me. You get that?
Amen.
That Jesus loves you.
Amen.
He loves you. Now I mean that.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
He wants to set you free. And he wants you to walk in the abundance of his life. He paid for it. He purchased it on the cross. No longer Catholics in this place. Jesus is no longer on the cross.
Yes.
It says he was buried. He died, he was buried, but he rose the tomb.
Hallelujah.
I think that's great. That God has given us power. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that a beautiful picture of the enemy behind us?
Yeah.
That got me. Because I used to like fighting before Jesus. And now you have to turn the other cheek.
Yeah.
You know? You do them. And it can be extremely hard at times. But you know, now we have a bigger fight. A bigger battle.
Mm.
But we are victorious in it.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. John 16 verse 19 says this. Again I tell you truly that if two of you on earth agree about anything you ask for, it will be done by my Father in heaven. For where two or three gather together in my name, there I am with you.
Amen.
And again I had this, I said earlier on, I'm not in the pictures, but I had this beautiful picture. And it's God wants to get into the battle with us. When you come together in my name, when you and someone else agree is something in my name, I am there with you. And he says, I'm going to go out and I'm going to fight your battles. I'm going to go out and be the one that goes before you. He says, I'm going to hem you in on every side. It says that I'm going to be a refuge in times of trouble. I am the righteous right arm. My strength is over you. Amen. And you can do all things through Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All things. Think we have authority over the enemy. Amen. that we have been given authority over the enemy. Every power, every principality, every spirit of the air, that God has given us authority over them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 I want to go and I want to fight your battles. For where two or three gather together in my name, there I am with you.
Hallelujah.
I've got a bit of a disclaimer in this, that last scripture. Because you sort of have to be very careful who you're coming in agreement with, don't you?
Yeah.
If I'm praying a prayer that she's believing for supernatural healing, and I'm being religious, and just say, oh, look, let that go a bit. If I'm not in agreement, well, my prayers mean nothing. So if I'm with the Conor McGregor, and they're wearing the belts, they've got the certificate hanging out of their pocket, but they're living a defeated life. Well, I'm not in agreement there, am I? So it's faith that pleases God. So when we come together over one thing in agreement, it says he will do it in heaven. He will answer that prayer. Amen.
Amen.
So you need to be careful that you're praying the right prayers. I was reading a book over the week about Smith Wigglesworth. And he was saying, you know, there was this woman and she was dying. And he goes to her house and he says to one of the pastors there. And the pastor says, oh Lord, when she dies, comfort the family. And the man Smith Wigglesworth was going mad. He was an amazing healer. And then you get somebody else to pray, the husband of the wife, and he says, well, Lord, when she goes, comfort me. And he loses his head. Because that's not a prayer of faith. That's not the prayer of faith. There's no death for the Christian, amen.
Amen.
There's only life and life in abundance.
Amen.
Where, O death, is thy sting?
Yes.
The sting of death has been taken away. Amen.
Jesus.
No death for the Christian. There's only life and life in abundance in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So if I'm praying, I'm going to pray life.
Yes.
All the time. Amen.
Amen.
If I'm believing, I'm going to believe for freedom all the time. Amen. I'm not going to ask God to put something more on that person. I'm going to tell the devil, take your hands off.
Yes.
I declare life over them. I declare freedom in the name of Jesus. Folks, why is this so strange coming from a pulpit? This life is supernatural from beginning to end. I've been born again of the Spirit of God. He says God got me when he was dead, when I was dead, and he made me alive.
Amen.
Is that not supernatural?
Yes.
That is supernatural. This walk is a supernatural walk, isn't it, Brenda? It says I'm cleansed by the blood of Jesus. That's what it says. I'm washed in the blood of Jesus. I'm pure as snow. That's what it says.
Yeah.
About me, about you. You're washed in the blood. Is that not blood of the Lamb?
Mm-hmm.
Picture that for a minute. I'm washed in the blood of Jesus. I'm washed in the blood of Jesus. His sacrifice on that cross. His life laid down for me and for you to pay the price for our sins. Pay the price for our sins. You need to take this serious, kiddo. You need to take this very serious. This is serious stuff. It's not a laughing matter. It's not a joking matter. It's serious. To take this serious, you'll walk in freedom.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the truth of it.
Hallelujah.
Take this serious, you'll walk in freedom.
Mm-hmm.
If you take God at his word, you'll walk in freedom. Mm-hmm. He says, those who walk in the truth never fall.
Amen.
That's what the Bible says. Those who walk in the truth never fall. It says we all fall. We all fall short. It says a righteous man may fall 7 times before he gets up. But if you walk in the truth as he is in the truth, as he is truth, you have fellowship with God. This is serious stuff. This is not for the faint-hearted. This is not for the weak. The blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin.
Hallelujah.
The blood of Jesus has power to heal every ailment of your body. The blood of Jesus has power to cast the devils and demons that have been in for so long. The blood of Jesus still has power today to wash you white as snow if you're dirty. We have ministered to prostitutes that have slept with millions of people. They repent at the love of God, and they have said to us, we feel clean for the full joy in their body. That's the power of the blood of Jesus. White as snow. Pure as snow. This is serious stuff, folks. This is not a club that we're joining here. It's not an add-on to my sobriety. This is the real deal. This is where the God of heaven and earth, the creator of the universe, wants to encounter you, wants to reveal his son to you, wants to change and transform your life and make you into that person. You know, there's not one person in this room that was born to be an alcoholic.
Amen.
Not one person in this room was born to be an alcoholic. You didn't inherit it. You didn't inherit it. Not one of us in this room was born to be a drug addict. Not one of us. Not one of us in this room under the sway of the wicked one. But the Lord on that cross made a public spectacle of your enemy. He triumphed over them. He bound them. He's behind them now.
Hallelujah.
There's power in the blood of Jesus. See, a lot of us like this stuff, don't we? We like the McGregor mindset. Hope he doesn't hear this preach.
We're going to send it to him, Hammy.
Now, if you ever saw him, they'll be a champion.
I'm sending it to him, Brenda.
Damn, oh, you're the biggest.
I did have a talk about McGregor going to this program.
Look, that's the case because I've been mentioning everybody from the pulpit. Got bashed by McGregor, I'm going to get shot by the Kinahan. There's not a lot of people I'll leave out at the pulpit here. Yes, thank you, Jade.
Hey!
Jade's gonna fight McGregor when. So, the thing about it is this.
Pity McGregor.
We take this stuff serious.
We do.
This is not for the faint hearted. I was weak, but now I'm strong. Amen. It says in my weakness, his strength is made perfect. It says his grace is sufficient in all things. Amen. Amen. And I'm not afraid of McGregor. Yeah, amen. But we have to get away from that mindset.
Because I was a champion, I'm now a champion. I need to walk in the freedom, amen.
Amen.
I need to walk as a champion.
Yes.
Isn't that right, Lee?
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Amen. Walk like a champion. Walk like a champion.
Got it all.
It's Brenda, she starts me off. She Amen. Look, God is so good, and we have to take this stuff serious because we have power over the enemy. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the blood of the Lamb to save, to change, to transform, and to make you into that person that God always intended you to be. Doesn't that sound good?
Yes.
Isn't that good news?
Yes.
Jesus came and paid the price for your sins.
Yes.
See, repentance is not just acknowledging. Did you know that? Bit of a shock right here. Repentance is not just acknowledging, oh yeah, I'm a sinner. Oh, there are sinners in there, so I'm going to go to you. That's not repentance. Did you know that? A lot of folks get this completely wrong. And you walk out of life defeated as a Christian. Repentance is taking hold of what Jesus Christ done for you on that cross.
Amen.
That will give you a heart of gratitude. And you will walk out the rest of your Christian life in victory.
Hallelujah.
Repentance is not just saying a prayer. Oh, forgive me, Lord. And going back into the pigsty. Repentance is jumping out of the pigsty and never going back into it. That's what true repentance is. Repentance is being so enough before God that you'll never do it again. Repentance is accepting what he done and living my life, the rest of my miserable life for him. That's true repentance. Because of what he has done on that cross. Because he paid the price for my sin. I am going to live, I am going to breathe, and I'm even going to die for him.
Amen.
That's true repentance. True freedom is allowing this world to have no hold on me. True freedom is not giving the devil a foothold in my life. True freedom is standing strong in the name of Jesus Christ, Adam, and putting the devil underfoot. It's shutting the mouth of the lion the voice in your head and saying, this far and no further, get behind me, Satan.
Amen.
That's what true freedom is. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to preach on this and this over the next 2 weeks. We're going to be going into something else. Amen.
Amen.
I was all over the place with being preached, by the way.
Great preach.
Great
message.
What I'm going to say is, and we're going to end on this. Do you believe that the blood of Jesus has the power to heal?
Yes.
Do you believe that the blood of Jesus has the power? I want to just say that again. Heal.
Yes.
Are you ready to let go of the chains?
Yes.
Are you ready to let go of the chains? Just let them go.
Amen.
Allow the Lord to open that lock that has kept you bound for so long and start walking out of this life in freedom. It's beautiful. There's nothing like the freedom of God. I'm telling you, there's nothing like the freedom of God. The Bible says, even though he slay me, yet I will praise his name. You know, my worst day, and I've had some bad days. My worst day with Jesus
is better than my best day in the world.
Amen.